one scotch, one bourbon, one beer. One scotch, one bourbon, one beer, yeah. Please, Mr. Bartender, listen here. I ain't here for trouble, so have no fear. One scotch, one bourbon, and one beer. I don't want soda.
Hi, my name is Alistair Burgess. I am Hunter 486 manager here at the Arch London, incorporating an English classic restaurant, a cocktail bar focusing on classically inspired drinks, harking back to old English good cocktails where we make a couple of homemade shrubs, focusing on gin, some scotch drinks in there, and some other whiskey drinks. We also have a champagne salon down to the side. We've got a champagne list of about 20 champagnes, Veuve Clicquot pouring and Rhinart Rosé, Billy Cart Salmon, and a few other specials there that hopefully people will enjoy. Tonight we're going to make you three Scotch drinks for Burns Night. Mine starting off is a drink called the 19th Century. It's a twist on a classic cocktail called the 20th Century, which is originally gin, Lillet Blanc, lemon juice and cacao. I'm taking out the gin and I'm going to put it in Talisker Scotch, replace the Lillet Blanc with Lillet Rouge, and have dark cacao in there as well as a sweetener. We're going to start with 40 mils of Talisker Early Scotch. Take our 20 mils of Lillet Rouge. Right, 20 mils of Crème de Cacao Dark.
Very good, thank you.
20 mils of freshly squeezed lemon juice. Shaken up with nice big clear ice cubes. And we're going to pour this out into a nice and chilled martini coupe. And here for Burn tonight we have what I like to call a 19th century cocktail.
Hiya, I'm Rupert Lovibond. I'm one of the head bartenders at Hunter 486 in the Arch. I'm using Glenkinchie because I wanted a very, very subtle, sort of soft kind of whiskey. So I'm using Lowlands. Lowlands, the classic triple distilled kind of soft whiskey. A nice, healthy 50ml measure. Bringing raspberry shrubs, so you know, like vinegar, sugar, berries, all infused. Okay, I'm going to be using French product, green chartreuse, quite potent at 55%. So a nice little kick to it. And I'm going to be using a Jamaican based sort of almost like lime alcoholic cordial. I mean, it's not very strong, it's only 11%, but it's got lots of flavour and it's kind of underused. I can see it coming back quite strongly in like something like a mojito or something classic.
Last but not least,
fresh lemon juice. All our cocktails be freshly squeezed lemon juice. Straight in there. With cobblers and smashers, what they used to do is they wouldn't actually add much fruit or any fruit to the drink, but they'd add like a kind of hectic garnish. A lot of your cocktails these days are quite plain, quite simple, and I feel like a lot of fun's gone out of it, and that's what this hotel's quite about. It's like a five-star environment, but without the snobbiness, it's just bringing back all the fun to cocktails. So you can see it's quite a blasé, over-the-top garnish. And then just finish with a dusting of sugar. And because I'm using the Velvet Fallon from Jamaica, Glen Kinchy, it's going to be called the Jamaican Glen.
So what are those things that are?
I'm Louis Hyams, I've been bartending now for 2 years. I have come from the York and Albany in Camden, a Gordon Ramsay group. I used to be a chef, started off chefing, and angled in to cocktail making about 2 years ago now. Today I'm going to make for you, it's an old-fashioned base drink. So today we're going to use aquavit. I love aquavit. It actually comes from Denmark. It's got a caraway character to it. I'm using a Spanish sweet sherry, probably the sweetest sherry there is. It's Pedro Jimenez. The whiskey I'm using is a Scotch Glenmorangie. It's an original 10-year-old, and it's quite light flavoured. Okay, so the aquavit, I'm going to put in 25 mils of aquavit. Yeah. 20 mils of the Pedro Jimenez. Yeah. 40 mils of Glenmorangie, 10-year-old. Two dashes of Peychaud's bitters. So I'm stirring this. This is to dilute the drink, to give it some dilution, and it's also to chill the drink sufficiently. Now I've got a chill glass. What we're going to do is what I made earlier. Check these out. Now I'm going to strain drink. I'm going to zest over some lemon. Discard the lemon just to give it the full notes and the smell. This drink is carried away because of the caraway seed in the extra bit. One scotch, one bourbon.